the web, and HTTP. In the last video, we discussed network applications in detail. In this video, we will discuss one of the most popular network applications, the World Wide Web, and its application layer protocol, Hypertext Transfer Protocol, or HTTP. So let us start. Initially, the internet was primarily used by researchers, academics, and university students. It was not popular among the general public. The internet gained popularity after the arrival of the most popular network application, the World Wide Web. With the arrival of the World Wide Web, people were able to build their websites at extremely low cost. With websites, people were able to share information, online shopping, book travel tickets, news updates, and so on. People get information whenever they want. They did not adjust their time as per the schedule of radio and TV broadcasts. These features made World Wide Web popular among the general public. World Wide Web is one of the network applications, and we know that network applications can have two types of architectures: client-server architecture and peer-to-peer architecture. We discussed these architectures in the last video. World Wide Web, or in short, the web, uses client-server architecture. Here, the client is a device which requests web pages, and the server is a device which stores and shares web pages. What is a web page? It is a single document which is accessible via a web browser. For example, this URL represents a single web page. A collection of web pages makes a website, for example, Wikipedia. Now, the client is requesting web pages and the server is sharing web pages. The request-response pair between the client and the server are transferred in the form of HTTP messages. HTTP, or Hypertext Transfer Protocol, is the application layer protocol that is implemented in the client program and the server program. An example of a client program is a web browser like Google Chrome. An example of a server program is a web server like Apache web server. When we open a web page on a web browser, we see that it contains some text, images, audio, or videos. These are called objects. Say, a web page contains some text and 5 images. It means that the web page has 6 objects. Web pages are written in HTML language. The HTML file contains text and links to other 5 images. So, when we open a web page, initially the web browser requests the HTML file. It interprets the HTML file and then requests the linked images using their URLs. At last, the web page is displayed on the computer screen. Please note that the object or a web page is transferred using the application layer protocol, HTTP. We know that HTTP uses TCP as its underlying transfer protocol. Since TCP is a connection-oriented protocol, the web browser first set up a connection with the web server. Once the connection is set up, the web browser and the web server access TCP through their sockets to share messages. The web browser sends an HTTP request message and the web server sends an HTTP response message. This is the format of a typical HTTP request message and HTTP response message. Please note that once a web browser sends the request message into its socket, the message is out of the web browser's hand and is in the hands of TCP. Now, one of the services of TCP is reliable data transfer. We discussed this in the last video. So, the HTTP request message sent by the web browser will arrive intact at the web server. Similarly, an HTTP response message from the web server arrives intact at the web browser. HTTP need not to worry about the data loss. It is the job of TCP and the lower layer protocols. let us first discuss the HTTP request message. Here, the first line is called the request line and the next lines are called header lines. At last, we have entity body. The request line has three fields: method, URL, and HTTP version. The HTTP version field stores the HTTP version a web browser implements. In this example, it is HTTP 1.1. URL field stores the URL of the requested object. Here, it is /dir/page.html. URL can be absolute or relative. For example, in this URL, we have protocol, domain, and path. URLs having protocol, domain, and path are called absolute URLs. On the other hand, URLs having only a path are called relative URLs. If the HTTP request message is first routed to a web cache, also called a proxy server, then the absolute address is maintained in the URL field. If the HTTP request message is directly routed to the origin server, then the relative URL is maintained in the URL field. The origin server is one that stores the original website. Method field can contain methods like get, post, head, put, delete, etc. The get method is used when a web browser requests an object from a web server. For example, entering a specific URL in the URL bar of the browser and hitting enter, or searching something in the search engine. Post method is used to submit data to the server for processing. For example, submitting a contact form on a website, or submitting address details on an online e-commerce site. The information which an end user provides is sent in the entity body. The head method is used by the application developers for debugging. When a web server receives a request with the head method, it sends a response to the web browser without the requested object. Put method is used to upload an object to a specific directory on a server. Delete method is used to delete objects from the server. Now, header lines. Here, we have four header lines. The header host specifies the host on which the requested object resides. Connection close tells the web server that it can close the TCP connection after sending the requested object. User agent indicates the browser type. Accept language indicates that the French version of the requested object is preferred. So, this is the typical format of the HTTP request message. Now, let us discuss HTTP response message. Consider this as the response message for the previous request message. HTTP response message has three parts: status line, header line, and entity body. Status line contains the protocol version, status code, and the status message. Here, protocol version is HTTP 1.1, which the web server is using. Status code is 200, and status message is OK. It means the request is succeeded and the requested information is returned in the response. These are some of the status codes in the HTTP response message. This response message has six header lines. The first one is connection close. With this header line, the web server tells the web browser that it will close the TCP connection after sending the response message. Date header line indicates the date and time when the web server generates the response message. Server header line indicates the response message is generated by the Apache web server. Last modified header line indicates the date and time when the object was created or last modified in the server. Content length header line indicates the number of bytes in the object sent in the response message. Content type header line indicates the type of the object in the entity body. Here, it is HTML text. At last, we have entity body. It contains the requested object. So, this is the typical format of the HTTP response message. Please note that HTTP is a stateless protocol because HTTP servers do not store any information about the clients. This means that if a web browser requests the same object twice within few seconds, the web server shares the same file again, instead of replying that the requested file is already shared. So in this video, we learned World Wide Web, Hypertext Transfer Protocol, HTTP request message, and response message. In the next video, we will discuss HTTP with persistent and non-persistent TCP connections. Thanks for watching.